We're here in Carlsbad, California. And what are we doing out here on the west coast of America? Well, we've been invited by Fujikura to come and have a look around the lab where they develop, prototype and test all of the shafts they make for the world's best players. It's a beautiful evening here, so we'll see you over there in the morning. Spencer, good morning.
Welcome,
nice
Simon.
To see you. How
good
are
to
you?
See you?
Okay, you're going to show us around.
We are. We're going to show you some cool stuff today, show you how we make shafts, show you a little bit of how we test shafts and all the good stuff in between.
Okay, so whereabouts are we going to start?
Let's start in the enso lab. That's the fun part.
Let's go.
Follow me.
Okay.
Pretty impressive.
Welcome to the enso studio. All right, so this is sort of the heartbeat of our R&D department, so to speak. So enso is our proprietary 10-camera motion capture system. What that actually does is it shows us exactly how a golf shaft behaves in space. So it shows us how much bending, deflection, twist, droop, all these things that we measure about how a shaft performs overall. We film that at several thousand frames per second, and we slow it back down so we can analyze every single part of it. So every single design that we produce is validated through enso analytics, and also it's a huge key in designing shafts as well. So this is a little bit of the final testing ground, so to speak. Mm-hmm. You'd probably like to see how we get to that point. So I'm gonna show you how we make a golf shaft.
All right.
So this is how every graphite shaft starts being a shaft.
Okay.
And it's solid sheets of prepreg carbon fiber material. Now we keep this at a constant temperature because this is prepreg, meaning it has carbon fiber as well as resin content. We want to make sure the resin doesn't get too hot or too cold when we take it out to start to work with it. So everything starts here. This is where we store all of the materials. Now a design sheet will come back to our production team back here. They will pull the corresponding materials. We can use all kinds of different materials and combinations of materials in our shaft design. So they'll pull that sheet out. After that, we'll bring it over here to our cutting table. This is a laser-guided cutting machine, and it cuts the exact specifications and flags that will eventually wrap around a mandrel that make a golf shaft.
Wow.
So depending on the complexity of the shaft, you can have 2 to 3 different types of material. You can have 10 to 14 different flag layouts. You can have 2 to 3. It all just depends on what we're trying to make. Now, after all those pieces are cut and laid out, they come over here, and this is where we start to build the shaft.
Okay.
Technician is doing here is he starts with a steel mandrel. This mandrel has notches cut out that we call clocking locations.
Okay.
That tells him exactly where he needs to lay each individual flag. So all of this is done by hand, and it's pressure rolled to get any sort of air pockets or any consistencies out of it. He'll do that again and again and again for each layer until we build up a shaft exactly how we want it. Now, while that is still on the mandrel, we'll bring it over here. This is where we actually seal the shaft. We're gonna wrap the entire thing, just to be sure there's no air pockets, everything's adhered to the mandrel as best it possibly can be. Then we're gonna heat cure it.
Okay.
After that step, it moves over here to the oven. We keep these at specific temperatures, depending on what we're trying to achieve, so that we can cure the material properly. Once the material is heat cured, we'll pull it out, and you'll see it right over here on this rack. This is what they look like when they come out of the oven. So we'll strip that plastic off, and then we'll extract the mandrel. What you're left with is a graphite tube. That's essentially the down and dirty explanation of how we make a golf shaft. Now the fun part is, after we make them, we break them.
Okay,
so that's when we move over here to durability testing. So what we're gonna do first is take all the specifications of a finished shaft. So you can see we check everything from CPM, butt stiffness, tip stiffness, swing weight, raw weight. Everything has to be in spec with the original design of the shaft before we go any further with it. After that, we start to get some more data. We'll start to go through EI curves. We'll start to look at exactly the bend point of a shaft, exactly how it bends, how it moves, where the soft spots are, and that all needs to correspond with the overall layout of the shaft. All right, now we've spec'd it, now we gotta tear it apart. All right, so then we move over here to our rag machine, excuse me, Jim. This is where we simulate shaft usage, right? So we're gonna clamp this at the top and the bottom and apply pressure and bend to the shaft. Then we're gonna oscillate the shaft to so many thousand revolutions per second to simulate usage in the field. What we do is we take the expected life expectancy of a shaft, and then we test well beyond that. So durability is a huge part of what we do when we design golf shafts. We have a lifetime warranty on all of our products that are purchased through our authorized dealers. We wanna be sure that everything we make, whether it goes to tour, production, You build it in your garage, whatever it is.
Pretty intense.
We want to make sure that every shaft is exactly how it is. The important thing for us is if you're fit for a product, we want to be sure that the product you order is just like the product you were fit for. So everything is as consistent as it can possibly be.
Right.
Now this is a full R&D prototyping facility, meaning we can make product start to finish, and that includes graphics and paint. So I'll show you our paint room.
Paint.
We'll go from there. Okay, so when we talk about full cosmetics in a shaft, we can paint, we can apply heat-treated decals, and we can do what we call silk screening. So if you look at maybe a product like Aventus, you'd have a solid paint job that we'll do here. You'd have a heat-applied decal that's Aventus with kind of the famous stripes on the band. Mm-hmm. And then we'll do what we call silk screening, which is essentially applying ink. That's where you see the Weight and Flex, the Fujikura logo, and with Ventus, you'll see that Velocor logo down at the bottom. We can do that completely in-house. And we put on a final clear coat, we bake it, and we can ship it if we need to. The cool thing about this facility is all of our aftermarket product, and really a mass majority of all of our product, is shipped right here from this facility. So after it all gets made, after it's all tested, after it's all done, I'm out the back. This is basically it. You can see where all of our parts are housed here, ready to be pulled, ready to be shipped. We keep a really tight control over our inventory, and we have a shipping crew that is the best in the business. They can get shafts in and out of this building faster than anything you've ever seen. But this is essentially where it all stops. So again, everything aftermarket ships out of this building. We usually average between 25 and 30,000 shafts going out the door a month. So we stay busy, we like it that way. But now, that's kind of start to finish. You've seen sort of the Enso process, the testing, that's more R&D. You've seen how we make them, you've seen how we ship them. That's kind of the nuts and bolts of Fujikura Composite America.
Wow, that's absolutely amazing.
Yeah.
I can't believe what's involved in making the golf shaft.
Yeah.
Really appreciate your time. Thank
you very
much.
A little fast and furious, but I hope it gave you some good insight.